Hello everyone, welcome to Nitsia channel. So today I have another tutorial that talking about broadcasting CG in Cinema 4D and we are going to compositing it in After Effects. So now I made the CG in Cinema 4D or 21, okay. And the first thing that we need to do is we go to Edit Render Setting and we are going to set up our presets. As you already follow my tutorial, you already know that I like to use HDTV, full HDTV with the frame rate 25. And then we are going to in here in the right side here. Project setting, if you don't see it, you can use the shortcut Ctrl D and it will appear like that. And we are going to change in here FPS, that stands for frame rate per second, from 30 to 25. So we are make sure that this frame rate and this frame rate is the same, okay? And we close it. Okay, so first of all, let's create our main thing. So I'm going to use start with plan, that this is our floor. So I will make it something high because it is the big scene, so around, okay, something big like that. So this is our floor. And then I'm going to create the background. So background the same we use with a floor, so we can copy it by click on it and use shortcut Control and drag it on, okay. And we rename it, and this one we can change orientation to Z, yeah, so it will become like that. And we move it back. Okay, then let's create something like in here in our example. So like the bar at the background like that, the strap, the bar strap like that. So we start simple with our rectangle part and we change the width 150, okay. And then move it to the back, something around here. And then we put it in extrude by clicking on it and press R and click extrude. With the shortcut key, number 1 is pan, number 2 is zoom, number 3 is orbit or key R also. Or key R is also orbit, okay. And then in this is true, we are going to go to cap and we change a bevel shape to curve and size 5. And then we can play around with this line to make a better shape that we want. Take a look. If I change the line here, the curve line here, so our shape, the curve shape is also changed. Or you can use a width preset by load preset here, and we have a lot of nice preset in here. You can use with here. Not bad. Please play around with it until you get the shape that you like. Okay, maybe something like that. I like it. And then we go in to put this extrude. We can rename it by DG. And then we go in to put it in cloner. here this icon. We click on the extrude, press R, and click on the cloner. So it will automatically apply on it. Or we can, if you don't see this icon in here, you can click on here, press R, and go to more graph, and you also see cloner in here also. And then we are going to change direction in here from Y. It means that it will duplicate or copy in the Y direction. That's not what we want, so we put it 0. We are going to copy it in the X position. Yes. Move it together like that. And then we are going to, you can see that it's overlap on the floor. We can move it up. Okay. To rotate it a little bit, you can go to cloner and transform by moving this like that. And then I'm going to rotate in here and transform here and 15. Then move it a little bit. Something like that. And then I'm going to make it on the right side. So you can copy and rotate it. But here I'm going to use with the symmetry. So we are going to click on here, this logo, subdivision surface, and we go to choose symmetry. Okay, and then we put our cloner in symmetry. Okay. Yes. So now we have two sides and we rename it BG. And now let's create some of the cube here, like the cube on the floor like that. So we create cube, and this is a small cube, only 30 cm. We can create the default camera first, or draft camera for us to easy looking. I'm going to use 25 mm. For example, something like that. We turn it off, and then we go to our cube. Is maybe it's 50 cm. Put it on the floor. And then just fill it. And only one. Yes. And then we are going to use cloner again and put this cube. Drag it into the cloner. Okay. And in cloner here, we can call cloner cube foreground. Oh, you. In object tab, in mode here, we use grid array and it will become something like that. Okay. We are not, if we take a look, this count here is count for in the X direction. If I increase it to 4, you can see that we will have 4 rows. And in here, in the middle here, is stand for the Y direction. If I increase it, you can see that now we have 2 rows. So just put it 1. And in the third column here, it stand for Z. If I decrease it, you can see that then in the Z coordinator, we have only 2, if 3. and or English 4, it will have 4 like that. So we will use 411. Okay. And then we move it into the floor, on the floor like that. And we are going to use some of the MoGraph to make it random. So I click on the cloner, I use MoGraph editor and plan. Okay, and in plan fall off, I going to use box sphere. So I change the size of the box to over effect on the cube. Okay, something like that. And in plan, I go to plan, I go to parameter. I'm not play around with Y position. I random it in X position and Z position. Okay, so now our cube is randomly, and we can change when we, you can see when we play around with the box. So I can, for easy looking, I can go to the top view to see how it shape. Okay, you can play around with how you organize the size of box sphere and then the position on it, and also play around with position in parameter or plane. So we create the random shape position like that. It is too many in here. So if you still difficult to it, we can just make it something like that. And then we are going to make it editable. So before we make it editable, we need to copy it for backup later. So let's copy cloner cube foreground control, and then we can turn it off, this one, and add it to new layer. And we can go to layer here, we rename it cloner cube foreground, and we can hide it in render out and also in the timeline. Okay, so now we only got this plan. Also we add into the layer that we hide, and in this cloner that we have copy, we can make it editable or with the shortcut C. Now we just got our cube. Okay, and then you can move around to the position that you like. Okay, make it something interesting. For example, if something like that, we still can move it. We still can set up it later after we set up the text and the other element. Okay, now let's move on to the next step. So now let's create the text and the text box, something like that. But here I use my language, so we going to create in English and the text here and also the box behind it. So first we create the box, the text box first. So we make it simple with rectangle part, and here we can rename text box and go to the object we use with 50 cm and 70. Or we can scale it a little bit, maybe 80 and 110. Here's something like that, and we check rounding to make it round, but it's too much. We round it around only 6 or maybe 10. Okay, 10 cm. And if we put it in extrude, so we click on it, press R and click on extrude. Okay, it's will apply on it, and depth here you can set up as you like. I use 15 cm, and we go to play around with the cap here. This time we use preset. I can okay, let's load some preset. Okay, I use 4 step here. I change the size a little bit, maybe around 3, and see what happens if I change the segment. Okay, only 25. I use 25. And I can play around with the line a little bit. You can see if at the final point here, it stands for this surface. So if I drag it down, the shape is also different. Okay. Okay, something like that. Okay, only 10, and I'm gonna use with the word, like I'm going to think about my text. I'm gonna write reports. So how many character in here? Reports. So let's write first, write the letter first. Reports. I'm going to think about the character here, how many character have in the words that I type. So I will create the box, follow the character. So reports. So there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 character. So 7 character, let's turn it off first. So we are going to have this cube, 7 cube. So I will use with, again click on the extrude here and rename it text box, and use more graph, press R and click on cloner, and then here we use 7 box we need 7 box and we not duplicate it on Y. We move it around on X. Okay, something like that. And we let's assign it the position on it. And then we can copy it again for backup. And this cloner, we move it around to the layer. Okay, and we can make it editable. Tab letter C. Okay, and this going to cloner box. This box. And now this is individual. Individual extrude.
Okay, because I want each character have the same axis center as the text box that it stand on, so I will not use more text in this condition. I will start with text part. Then I set its position. Now let's type the first character, its letter O. And change the position of letter O on the middle of text box. Change the font. And apply extrude in it. Click on the text, hold R, and click extrude icon. And change the depth, movement. And play around with caps. Now let's set up the axis center of the letter, follow the axis center of text box. Let's rename it to letter O for easy recognize. So what I want is, I want axis center of letter O have the same value as axis center of text box behind it. Now I rename this box to text box O for well organized. As you see, the axis center of letter O is at there. So in order to change its position to the same as text box O, we need to drag extrude letter O to be a child of text box O. And then click on extrude letter O. After that, we enable axis modification icon. And we change its position here to YU000. Okay, now the axis center of extrude letter O has the same position as axis center of text box O. Now we can drag extrude letter O out of it. If we take a look on its axis center of these two objects, now it stays in the same place. Now let's create another character. We copy from letter O. Before we move position, make sure you uncheck this icon. If you not uncheck, you will move the position of axis center and the object not moving. So you need to uncheck the axis modification icon first, then you can move the object. And let's change the text to letter E. And we follow the previous step. You want the exit center of letter E has the same position value as text box behind it. These two objects contain almost the same value of exit center, so I think you don't have to change anything. Let's move to the next character, it's letter P. So I copy it and change to letter P. Rename the text box to P. As we see, these two objects don't have the same axis center. So let's do the same technique. But before I do it, I want to explain why I want axis center of the letter have the same position as the extrude text box behind it. If I create the fracture for making motion, and for example, I drag this extrude P and this box to the fracture. Now let's review solo single for A0. As you see, these two objects don't have the same position of axis center. So the problem is when we create animation like rotation, it will have a problem. But this you don't see any problem because the axis center of letter P is almost the same as axis center of text box P. But if I change the coordinate of axis center of letter P to somewhere else that completely far or different from the axis center of text box P, now you see it's not rotate properly. Why is like that? Because the axis center of letter P is different from axis center of text box P. So now let's adjust the axis center of letter P to have the same value position as the text box P. By drag it as a child with text box P, then animal axis center modification icon and change the position of axis center of letter P to 000. Okay, now these two objects have the same position of axis center and we drag it out. Now if we rotate it again, you see it rotates properly. So this is a reason why I want the axis center of extrude letter have the same position as axis center of the text box behind it. Let's make another character. Don't forget to uncheck axis modification icon when you're moving object. Okay, now we finish with our take. We can change the position of group take to the middle of the scene. Now, let's move to the next step. We will create the signal sign on the left and right. I start simple with act and change start angle and angle. Then put it in switch generator. Select on act, press R and go to switch. And create a rectangle part, put it into the switch and above the axe. Adjust width and height of rectangle. And play around with cap of switch. Then, let's move X center of switch to the center of the object. Let's create another signal by copy it and change its size and position. Let's group it. And put it in symmetry. Now let's create the scene that we put the footage, video or picture of reporter. So I create with plan, change the orientation to +8. And change its width and height. Make sure the position is on the floor. Then I put it into the cloner. After we get these two sides, let's make it editable. Before make it editable, please copy it for backup later. Okay, now we're almost done with our scene setup. Now let's make another detail line on the floor. We start simple with pen tool. We create a simple line with top view. Then we put it in the sweep generator. Okay, thank you very much for watching this video. So see you in the next video. We will be talking about animation. We will be talking about more graph of the tech and how I create camera motion with mob camera. See you in the next video. Good luck. Stay home and stay safe.